Episode 5 of the Bash Pod is brought to you by Bang Energy. When you just want to bang one out.
That's great.
Alright. With you as always, I'm Luke Spicy Boy Spicer, and this is Brian Swagaback Romero. And we got a special guest today. Ben Donahue. Here.
It's true. It's real.
We're going to ask him the hard-hitting questions about the Marine Corps and about Catholicism.
Two topics I love.
All right, we're going to start off, though, as we always do. Brian, what's your word of the day?
Gastronomical.
Definition?
It's the part of your calf that you just really hate when it gets a cramp. It's just gastronomical.
Word or root language?
Eastern Swahili.
Alright. Yeah, you can.
Oh, I was banging one out and my gastronomical was furious and plantarific.
But also, word of the day is brought to you by Peg. By Bang. When you want to bang one out with whoever you're with. Alright, we're driving to Memphis. Yeah, that's right, the dirty south.
The homeland of fried potatoes and pickles.
Alright, I'm gonna see if I can prop this up, baby. I don't know how that'll work out. Okay, whatever. No, it's not holding. I'll just hold it. Actually, if I hold it right here, it's comfortable and I can see all of us. Like partially see all of us, but not all the way see any one of us.
You see the good parts of me.
Yeah.
There's good sides.
Ooh. Ooh. That was 10 more than I was going to give myself.
So what are we going to Memphis for, Brian?
One, I have a gynecologist up there, real good, really hands-on. He's going to teach me how to make my way with the ladies. Some of y'all don't know, I'm in a little bit of a dry spell. I picked up a few girls like 5 weeks ago, and they weren't girls at all.
They were women.
Thank you. I was going to say that. No rapey vibes around here. Hate the rapist. But supposedly sometimes put in the wrong hoe.
Watch out, construction on road ahead.
Hey, first off, you calm down with that, Siri. But yeah, put it in the wrong hole. Supposedly, I didn't know there was more than one. Apparently, the belly button's not the proper one. My 6S class failed me once again. But yeah, I go see a gynecologist. Ben, he's trying to figure out, if he wants to be a man or a boy or both. Please himself and please someone else at the same time. Who would have thought? Luke is just on board just because he's paid for all of it.
Financier.
Yeah. He's sugar daddy, a.k.a. spicy daddy, a.k.a. has no daddy, a.k.a. probably is daddy.
Not wrong.
No.
Police reported ahead.
Shut up.
All right. If we get pulled over, don't worry. We'll live stream the whole thing.
Sorry. We got an American killing machine with us. He fought for our country. You gonna give us a ticket, dick?
Yeah, and Ben is strapped right now in more ways than one.
Mm-hmm.
He's got probably one of the top 50 or 60 bodies I've seen. he has 12 siblings. Ben, since I have you here, can you just let the people know once and for all what a quick and dirty is?
It's more complicated than that, right? So usually quick and dirty, I know your mind starts going to these places, but it's actually chocolate with little oats in it, and you make them and you hand them out to women at parties, and it really
the approval rating?
It's like a 9
higher than Biden's.
69% over here.
Yeah, what you do is you go up to a young gal who needs some chocolate, and you say, hey, do you want to go to the back room for a quick and dirty? And then you get there, and it's a delicious treat.
Is it really quick, though?
Yes.
I like it.
It's like a 30-second experience.
It's 29 seconds longer than me, my friend.
Negative 35 longer than me. Or 35.
Wait,
I messed that up. That would imply that I would last 65 seconds.
Don't worry, we're cutting that up.
I was trying to say that I would last negative 5 seconds, like I would finish before we even started. Never mind.
Oh, the
editor will cut that out. I'm the editor. Finance or the editor.
He just does it all.
Co-host.
He's pretty much Hillary Clinton.
We may not make it back after that.
People tell me. I'm the Hillary Clinton of podcasting, of low view podcasting.
Hey, low views. We got about 100 views.
Like, all together.
Yeah.
Like, combined. It's a running total.
Sorry.
But we've never had a guest like this before.
That is true. I don't think we've ever had a guest. You're our first guest.
I'm your first guest.
Wow.
Well, you set the bar low. It's all up from here.
Popping the cherries, as I might say.
Yeah.
So, Ben, as a part-time member of the Marine Corps, do you find yourself hanging out down at the marina often?
Like twice a month, maybe. I mean, it's low commitment. You kind of do it when you're comfortable. It's the easy way in.
I do have one question about the Marines. Is it true that when you're in San Diego, are there prostitutes on base?
Can't answer that question.
It's classified.
Sign up with the link below. Go to San Diego for yourself and find out.
This whole episode is just like propaganda to get people to join the Marine Corps. The reserves.
If you want American prostitutes, join the Marines, baby.
You used to have to play basketball for Rick Pitino to get this kind of do it right here at the Marine Corps.
You said it's been several weeks. You joined the Marine Corps. Get you out in a month. Get you out there.
Are you on a dry spell? Join the Marine Corps. Brought to you by Bang Energy. When you want to bang one out with a prostitute in the Marine Corps. Bang!
I feel like I'm going 85 and they're just passing me like nothing. Should I go faster?
You're doing fine, baby.
I'll hold this real quick. I gotta take a rip.
A rip? Oh, I can't flip the camera around or something like this. Just get into a little street view for a second. GeoGuessr.
You gotta flip it over because suddenly they're gonna be looking at it though.
Oh, yeah, true.
What a dumbass.
Whatever.
Although he's our editor. Not a good film.
He'll edit that part out too.
Yeah.
I hated that part of you. We are opener.
That's going to be the clickbait.
Get that.
An upside down view of the road.
How'd they get upside down? What if Brian flips the car, then we'll be right side up? And he's dipping right now, so. Definitely in a potential flip scenario.
Multitasker.
Can eat ass and cut hair at the same time.
You know what? I'm not gonna say it.
What?
I'm gonna have kids on one day.
Dude, if your kids watch this one day, it's already gone.
Actually, a few found out that I had a podcast.
How would they have found out other than if you just told them?
I did tell them.
You did tell him?
I didn't, so I don't know. I'm thinking Marcus, Tim's little cousin, he might have spoken something.
He was there.
And so, whether they've been trying to find it, I'm hoping to God they don't ever.
kids, brought to you by Bang Energy. When you want to
bang one out.
Bang one out isn't their new slogan.
Well, we should get sponsored by them.
Matt, I mean, pretty much single-handedly keeps them in business.
Yeah. So, LaCoy, so I got a question for you.
Yeah.
It's kind of personal, so kind of not.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so say in general, speaking for men, ass or tits?
I'm a booty man, first and foremost. Much like a pirate would be. And Brian, I believe you put it so eloquently yesterday when you said that if you have big boobs and no butt, you look weird. If you got a big booty and small boobs, you look great.
Couldn't say better myself.
I believe that was a direct quote from
Swagger Bay.
Oh, that's he.
Yeah.
Colonel Custer.
What about you, Ben Frank? Ass or tits? As a Marine, you're allowed to say personality, but we know you don't mean it.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm kind of along the same lines as Spicy Boy here. It's which one's better for the people? You know, you gotta think about more than yourself.
That is true.
Gotta think about something bigger than yourself. Join the Marine Corps, brought to you by Bang Energy. When you want to bang one out on a base in San Diego.
The way I look at it, too, is besides the whole looking weird, is that when a female gets older, usually, the boobs start to sag down better, And so, if they have big boobs, they're just going to get even worse when they get older. But with an ass, when's the last time you've seen an ass sag? Oh, usually, if a girl has a nice ass, she's going to want to keep that up, So, yeah. It's going to look nice when she gets older.
However, the counter argument to that would be fake boobs.
Yeah, but you gotta think, fake boobs just look weird. Like when they're like small, when they get like a.
Well, you don't want them too big.
Yeah, when you get like.
Carmen has very nice fake boobs.
Does she have fake boobs?
Yeah.
What it knows.
Exactly.
Honestly, I can admit right now, I have not looked Carmen in the face. Person I don't recall that. He's talking about Luke.
I read it online somewhere.
Put it on Yelp.
Hoping that the three of us can keep it to a manageable level.
Yeah, so what if, like, say right here, maybe some bloods or crips come in, take us over, and they just wreck Airbnb and leave. What happens to them?
Let me charge it to the game.
I hope they have a good lawyer and accountant. They're going to get that. Really?
say Miley Cyrus and none of the other ones.
I don't know, I kind of like the J's on my feet, Miley Cyrus.
I don't even know what that is.
J's on my feet. Here it is.
Yeah, I don't remember what it went down. No, I feel like it had gone downhill by 2015. But
see, 2013 was Wrecking Ball, though.
Yeah, I want, that's what I want. Leave that here. Wait, was she licking the wrecking ball? Is that when she went downhill? Mm-hmm. I don't know about that. I went going Party in the USA. She was so hot Party in the USA.
The long hair, right? Oh, short hair is really not my thing, but I think she kind of pulls it off sometimes. I bet she'll be a wild ride, though.
Same as y'all. Maybe this was a boring segment. I mean, you know, I had the siblings over, spent the night at Papa Spice's.
Papa Spice.
Woke up to some yummy breakfast, and we opened presents. I got some cute undies. I got some polos.
Yeah, you did.
My grandma got my dad the exact same polo that he got me.
Oh, so you are Twinkies.
We are twinsies. Yeah, that's about it.
Look at all those chickens.
Let's move on. There's cows on the side of the road. That's what Brian's referencing. Let's move on to literally any other segment.
So, Ben, walk us through boot camp.
Well, it's a lot of fun. You show up, they start yelling at you. Kind of have no clue what's going on. They keep yelling at you. You're just kind of doing what everyone else is doing, trying to figure out what you're supposed to be doing. You work out a lot. It's the most successful weight loss program I've ever heard of in my life.
I have to try it.
I saw a lot of transformation. I saw a lot of successful weight loss. Unfortunately, no footage of that. That was no cameras allowed, so we didn't get a chance to film the success, the journey. But man, it's a lot of fun. You're there with a bunch of your buddies, just having a good time for 3 months.
This sounds amazing.
You don't sleep, you hang out, you get yelled at, you work out.
So what do you bring?
Shoulder ahead.
Is there a point you'd like this sucks right now?
So, not for me. I didn't really think anything sucked, but actually the USO at the airport over there is when you first get your first taste, and they start yelling at you there before you even get to the depot. And some people start questioning why they showed up, why they actually got on that flight. But,
anybody like to say, like, I'm done with this?
Not for a while. You spend every day with the same people, so, you know, if your buddy can do it, you can do it too. And you don't really want to quit when your buddies don't do the same thing right next to you, so.
Nice.
I mean, it's a great team building. It's a great bonding experience. So, again, if you've been dry, haven't had any friends or anything for weeks, hit up the Marine Corps. Link in the description.
Make
60 to 90 friends in 30 days. 90 days.
Is the Raleigh Shore thing, do y'all say that?
Yeah.
Can you do the, what's it, the Frogman chant or whatever?
Frogman chant? That would be a, maybe in the Navy, the Seals Bay. Frogman.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe some strength.
Troublesome.
What rank are you?
I am E3 or Lance Corporal, so part of the.
So you control Lance, you're kind of a Lance guy?
Yeah. questions before I came. I couldn't prepare any answers, so I'm on the spot here.
So did you ever think about going to the SEALs? Or do you even think about it, or do they just say, like, hey, you should try this out?
Well, if that's in the Navy, no, I have not. And yes, like, you can request to go try it out.
So if you're a Marine, there's no hope in you being a Navy SEAL?
There is. I mean, there is hope. You can still go. You just have to talk to a chain of command and tell them, hey, I want to try this. I want to go do that. And then, I mean, it depends on your chain of command. Maybe they'll run a fitness test on you to see if you're, you know, even serious about it. And then if you're, you know, if you're for real, they may ship you out.
So they do a psych test on you?
I believe the SEALs do, but the people that I know, that your chain of command doesn't do that. They just, if you're physically fit enough, they'll give you the chance, and then...
So I've always heard that if you're, like, extremely, like, in shape and, like, a big dude, like, the SEALs is going to suck for you, because they're supposed to go first.
It's a lot of running. Well, pretty much everything in the military is just a lot of running, so if you're used to just lifting weights and not really running, it's going to be... I personally did not run a lot before I joined, so I felt some difficulties in running. Push-ups, sit-ups, pull-ups, like, all that stuff was fun, but sometimes in running, when you run, like, every single day, so if it's not what you like doing, some days it's going to be tough.
Yeah, I don't think I've done a pull-up day in my life.
You gotta do at least 5. No, that's it. You get shit down. You gotta do more than that.
Right.
So, like, what if you get there?
Like, the start.
Yeah, like, what if you get there and, like, you're in PT, like, I can only hit, like, 3. And, you know, I'm just like, do they just, like, start yelling at me?
Yeah, they yell at you in the squad bay where they have, where everyone sleeps. They got a pull-up bar, so. Eventually, they'll give you like an hour of free time, and you will spend that hour exercising, doing pull-ups. So
if you can't do something, does that affect the whole squad?
Yes.
So I'd get roasted a lot.
Yeah, you might be the problem for everyone else.
How much more difficult is Marine boot camp versus just like generally enlisting in the Army? gotta drop down. Drop Brian down. give him enough air for a couple hours and a couple natties.
Oh, yeah, could you drink them?
Well, in, like, boot camp, no, you don't. There's, for the Marine Corps anyway, there's no alcohol, there's no tobacco, there's no electronics. Like, your food's controlled, your sleep's controlled, everything's, you know.
What y'all eat? MREs?
Yeah, sometimes. Sometimes you eat MREs, like, if you're out in the field or something, but they've got, like, chow halls there, so...
Vehicle on shoulder ahead.
Shut up, Siri. If I had more self-control and just, like, self-discipline, I think I could just be rocking like a fucking rock body. But, just not that discipline.
I might argue that's the case for everyone, but I would agree.
There's a case for, I mean, nutrition is definitely the goal.
Because, like, healthy food, I love healthy food. Like, chicken, rice, doing some vegetables, like, I would eat that shit all day.
Dude, the stuff you cook is good.
Yeah, it's just those days that I'm just like, I don't feel like doing this shit. The days I lose.
You gotta do better than McDonald's.
I really don't eat McDonald's a lot. Like, if I do eat McDonald's, usually it's for breakfast. Nice egg muffin with some jelly. I think my biggest weakness is why I surely do.
It's what?
A little Mexican place. I eat there quite a bit, like, every day.
Really?
Yeah.
You gotta make a big meal at the beginning of the week, and then we use leftovers.
That's right, that's...
Yep. It's gonna commit.
Yeah. Meal.
Write something in the comments about Brian and what he needs to eat to get the perfect body. Drop a meal plan in the comments for Brian.
Oh, yeah.
Don't forget to like and subscribe.
You're right.
It's like just Matt and maybe Jared watches.
Hey, if y'all leave a meal plan, he's going to follow it for 1 month.
Watch out, construction on road ahead.
He'll follow the plan for 1 month, and we'll get before and after weigh pictures. We'll show you the progress.
Amen. 15 pounds, here I come.
Hey, you did it.
I did do it.
You've done. You dropped like 30.
Around there.
Nice.
Now it's all coming back.
Is it?
Oh, I'm praying.
Alright, we'll just do barbecue chicken this weekend. And light beer.
Light beer. This thing, like, I can do good for like 2 or 3 weeks, and then when I go on like vacation or I'm out of school, oh, it's hell. Because all I do is sit around and just eat whatever the shit I find. Drink a lot more.
Yeah, you'll have
to hang out with
them. Alright, we'll eat healthy this weekend. I'll show you the path to the chisel frame. It's long and arduous.
Yeah, I'll take it. Yeah, I'll follow you.
You clearly haven't seen my political platform. Don't forget. had to vote for the mayor of Christmas. We have the two leaders in the car today.
Now, I started a slow race, but like they said, you can start slow.
And then he starts to blow. He's been blowing guys for votes, I know it.
I haven't. Yeah.
He's definitely doing something.
I really don't know what it is. I think it's my vocabulary. I use people love it. I'm a guy's guy. What is American Texas all about? I'm sitting right here. You know, there's three things in this world I love. Guns, America, food. Capitalism. Non-socialistic.
Alright, one final word from our sponsor. Once again, we are brought to you today by Bang Energy. Don't forget the reason for the season. It's Jesus' birthday. Merry Christmas. Bang went out with